What up? It's the Trooper. Monday. I just realized that I didn't bring any sparkly rocks for myself today. I don't like to leave home without sparkly rocks. I did, however, bring 2 dozen sparkly pops for a pop drop at another casino. The guy who I dropped them to said some encouraging words, and I want him to know that I appreciate it. One of the things that he said to me is something that other people have said in the past, and it's something that I appreciate probably more than anything else, you know, that people get from my videos, and that is that I'm honest, that I tell the truth, that I say it the way that I believe it, the way that I see it. And I think that if there was one thing about me that I would want people to take away from my videos, is that I'm honest, that I tell the truth. I always tell the truth. If I don't want to tell the truth, I just don't say anything at all. And there's nothing fake about my vlog. There are a lot. I mean, it's just more common than not. YouTube channels, social media in general, Instagram accounts, there are a lot of fake ones. A lot of, you know, look at me, look at how perfect everything is, type of thing. When it's not true type of thing, you know what I'm talking about. I don't know how to put it into words exactly, but if there's one thing I hope you take away from my vlog, it is that it's real, it's true. There are pros and cons to everything, but at the end of it all, it's only a pro to tell the truth. That's it. That's my inspirational speech of the day. I am on the strip to play poker, and before I do that, I think I'll grab a little coffee, and where should I grab that? I mean, the closest decent coffee, the best closest coffee. So a combination of the closest and the best that I can get my hands on at the moment, Starbucks at Bellagio. I gotta figure out, do I want hot or cold? Cold or hot? Or both? Say I won't get both. I dare you to say it. I dare you to say that I won't get an iced coffee and a hot coffee. Try me. All right, I'm probably just gonna get one, but I would, if you said it, if I heard you say it, I'd probably get, you know what I mean. We'll be right back. interesting place, this Las Vegas. The excitement may have worn off a little bit, but it remains one of the most interesting places. The list of the horseshoe, long, long list. I put my name on them anyway. I'm gonna go over there to the World Series and find a game to plop down into for a little while. A little too much milk. A little heavy on the milk today. Poor cows. What? Shout out to the people who I just saw on the little bridge over there. Thanks for watching my videos.
Hey, it's Marcel. Shout out to McDougal with the Trooper. Go gamble.
Thanks for watching the videos.
You bet.
Got late, y'all. We got late, and I'm stuck to 27. So I decided to quit. Remember the days when I would stay and play until 5, 6 in the morning? I just don't feel like doing that anymore. I mean, I could do it, you know what I mean? And I thought about it tonight. I was like, you know, I should just stay. The game is decent, you know? Let's just stay. But I don't want to do it. It cuts into tomorrow, right? Tomorrow's Tuesday. It's another day. I registered for the Colossus for Saturday. So we got some Colossus action going. And, yeah. Wednesday at 1 p.m., I will be doing the Go Gamble podcast live with clubs and producer Mike. What is the world coming to? People used to have like a sense of like, wow, maybe I shouldn't wear this. Maybe I look ridiculous, or maybe I shouldn't behave this way because it's absurd. That's all gone, at least it seems to be around here. No one has any shame whatsoever. Everyone in the world seems to be getting more and more selfish, more and more greedy, obviously more and more shameless, definitely more and more crazy. You know, I considered walking over there and asking that Uber driver if he's ever heard of a crosswalk. But you know, as crazy as people are, I'm not looking to be in a gunfight out here on a Monday night in Vegas. I came down here to play poker and make a vlog, not be involved in a gunfight. Ever since an early age, I have had a fondness for the city. Whatever city, you know what I mean? Action, hustle, bustle, lights, lots of people. But I gotta tell you, it's getting to a point that I'm getting sick of it. Quite sick of it, especially given the state of humanity these days. I mean, when I was a kid, everybody was polite, or at least had some manners. Everybody understood when they walked in front of someone or cut someone off or, you know, when someone held the door open for them, you know, at the supermarket or wherever. You know, like when you're in the supermarket and you're shopping and you're in the aisle and you're looking at a shelf and a guy walks between you and the shelf you're looking at, everyone used to say, excuse me, or pardon me, or sorry, or something like that when they walk by. And it was basically, it's not like it changes your life, but what it does do is sort of demonstrates that there's still a certain level of respect for other humans. What the fuck is going on in this elevator, dude? I mean, just as I stand in this elevator, the smell in this elevator is reason enough for people to just give up. For people to just give up on manners. I mean, Las Vegas is a shithole, okay? It is a cesspool. Literally and figuratively. You know, what it really comes down to is sure, overall, it's a sense of morality, you know? A sense of morality, or a lack of a sense of morality, is the underlying condition. But really, it just seems to be selfishness. People are so selfish, and it just shows in a way, it's beginning to show itself in ways that I feel like, I mean, maybe the earth has seen before, you know, maybe in ancient history, you know what I mean? But like, it's funny because a lot of people think about social media as like the root of a bunch of problems, right? What is making everyone so selfish? Envy and greed, pride. Careful what you say. It is Pride Month. Just over the past few years since I moved to Vegas, I feel like I am witnessing a decline in decency. Yeah, even in Vegas. Vegas seemed a lot more decent just 8 or 9 years ago. And I don't know, maybe I would see this no matter where I am. If I was living in the middle of Utah, if I was in Oklahoma, if I was in Idaho, I'm sure I would see the same thing. Or would I? I don't know. And as I think of doing things outside of poker, you know, as I think of doing things that I probably should have done decades ago, you know, that have nothing to do with poker, as I think and consider doing those things, you know, I think of myself doing those things here in Vegas. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.